data science field is growing rapidly now, right? So because of that, what's happening is that there is clearly a shortage. Just like if you can imagine, maybe about 10 years back or even 15 years back, there was a shortage of people who were good at engineering, Web 1.0, people who are good at sort of Java programming, those kinds of things. You see the same kind of trend happening in data science now, where you find people, there are not enough people who understand how data works, how to make sense of data, what is data trying to tell you.
And I think that what we're seeing, particularly in the news with like a lot of a lot of discussion about, you know, the power of algorithms and, you know, what is the role of algorithms in, you know, society, is that these algorithms are starting to move into this area of actually making a lot of decisions for us. And so it's less about describing what's happening and more about actually deciding what's happening.
What students are doing in the classroom is very similar to what they'll be doing in the workplace. I think students recognize that almost immediately when they start the program, and that gets them more excited.
So the combination of being able to not just jump to a finished product, but really kind of work hard on the problem itself on your own or in a small group, and then see a range of solutions really was the most beneficial thing for me.
Making sure my class helps students advance in their careers and advance personally, professionally, is the most important goal of my class. And I encourage students to think of this as their first portfolio piece, as the first time that they're, or for students that already have a portfolio, as a new portfolio piece, a way to show potential employers, a way to show other people that they are able to build something that is insightful, that is clear, and that explains complicated issues in a way people can understand them.
I feel like having a portfolio of your work is really important, especially if you want to have some authority on an issue. You want to be able to hand someone and demonstrate, look, I've done this before, or I know what I'm talking about, or how about we try this thing that I did over here. And I thought a lot of the courses seemed to be structured around the idea of building a portfolio of projects and working collaboratively as much as possible.
It's practical implementations that you have to show, that you have to write code for. And that's what the field demands. You have to be able to write some sort of code or do some sort of work in order to implement these tools in the field. And without kind of CUNY SPS having the really focus on the technical implementation, I would not be nearly as successful in being able to actually take these tools and use them in a practical situation.